Kenny, on evidence of Saturday, it's all knitting together extraordinarily well.
Well, we needed it. We thought we'd, you know, had some good performances in some ways so far, but you know, Saturday was, you know, we think the most comprehensive, and particularly out the home games where we look the most cohesive. But we do feel as well that there's more to come, and you know, we need to improve a certain aspects as well that we can improve on. You always have to feel that way, particularly in early season. You have to aspire to try to be better. From myself now, if we can settle the side down, really make sure that sort of, you know, behind that we have subs that are ready to come on and change the game, which is a big thing, then that's, you know, part of the winning equation. And you know, a settled side, a settled group is, you know, coming out of pre-season now what we're aspiring to do, because if we can do that, we feel as we keep working at the game, we'll get better.
You can't have done any more than you've done in the first three league games. Do you notice an up in morale on the training pitch?
I certainly hope so, and I do think, speaking to them today, they're a capable group, but again, you have to earn everything that that you get. Nobody's going to give you anything. It is only three games in, and you know, for us it's a long season, so you know, we want to just set some markers really, if we can, and also say where we need to improve, because there's areas that we do both in and out of the club, and if we can, with a, you know, a fair amount of luck with injuries, we feel that we can build on what we've done and continue to get better.
It always takes just one game to come a cropper, and Bristol Rovers tomorrow night won't be an easy game.
That's a tough division, and the top 10 of this division are very good, and Bristol Rovers will be one of the clubs, big club and great support, and they'll be looking to try to get there as well, obviously, you know, as they have been for a couple of years after coming out of League Two. Going to Bristol was never an easy game. They have a fantastic home record, and you know, we're fully aware of exactly what we're coming up against, and that we'll need to be at our best to earn anything out of the game.
Will it need to be a kind of different game tomorrow night than it was on Saturday?
I don't think so. I think we try to, you know, play both sides of the game, and always, you know, if we have to, you know, work hard, defend and battle, that's part of it, but also, you know, be constructive and creative in possession to make sure that we can play the football that can get us the chances. So, you know, both sides, whether it's home or away, our approach won't change. You know, we won't play slightly different one or the other. And also, you know, we do what we've got to do to try to win the game, and that's, you know, that's a fact as well. But, you know, we go away from home, we go on the road this week, and, you know, we have to make sure that we don't sort of rest on our laurels from Saturday, and we have to earn everything we get.
One assumes that there wouldn't be too many changes in the offing tomorrow night.
No, we were waiting on, and we still are, just maybe waiting on one or two players, one or two knocks. But I think they'll both be fine. And as you say, hopefully we can, you know, settle the group down, make the right changes at the right time, and you know, benefit from perhaps, you know, a bit of competition and strength.
Back over the other side, Donoghue and Thompson back in training.
Yeah, we hope that. You know, both are okay this week. You know, we're optimistic. There weren't major injuries, which is good. And, you know, both have a lot to offer, and a lot to offer Portsmouth during the season.
And your league paper manager of the week, do those accolades mean a lot to you?
I hadn't read that. I hadn't seen that one, to be honest with you. But, you know, it's always the next game anyway, whether you win, lose or draw is in my mind, as a coach, that's how I feel. And obviously, you know, you get confidence off winning, definitely, and the players do. But we have to look forward. I always look forward onto the next game. And in League One, they're coming thick and fast. So, you know, pleased with Saturday. But straight away after, you have to be thinking Bristol Rovers and then Doncaster. You know, travel arrangements. First off, getting things right off the pitch so that, you know, the players can do their best and perform on the pitch.
Just a random question here, which we like to do sometimes. Fourth officials, do you have some sympathy for them?
Yeah, you know, I think it's you know, part of the job. You get an ear bashing, don't you, for fourth officials. I know that they accept that, and many of them will just say, well, yeah, I understand what you're saying, what do you want me to do about it, because he's not the guy out there either. But I've got to say, referees and fourth officials and assistant referees, it's not something I focus on, to be honest with you. You know, they've got a job to do. We are all affected, and when I'm asked questions about them, because sometimes they do affect the game that we're in, you know, so I do always want to give an honest answer of maybe decisions and that have affected the game. But generally though, in terms of like management and coaching, you know, I don't focus on, you know, officials at all, to be honest with you. If I had to just go that way, I think I'd do something else in life. Yeah.